Welcome to SNN TV News English. My name is Adam Mohammed Osman. I'm here to update you on the daily news. These are the stories making the headlines. President of Somaliland sends condolences to the public over the death of the late mayor of Hargeisa. Minister of Finance for Somaliland meets the Financial Subcommittee of the House of Representatives. A divided Sarajevo city strives to reintegrate. The President of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud, sent his condolences to the public over the death of the late mayor of the capital of Somaliland, Hargeisa, Yusuf Warsame Said. President Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud made a supplication to Allah to provide mercy upon the soul of the late mayor. The President of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud, sent his condolences to the Somaliland public, as well as the family and friends of the late mayor of the capital of Somaliland, Hargeisa. President Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud supplicated to Allah to provide mercy upon the soul of engineer Yusuf Warsame Said. The late mayor of the capital of Somaliland, Yusuf Warsame Said, passed away early Sunday morning in a hospital in Dubai where he had been receiving medical treatment. Yusuf Warsame Said was elected just a few months ago, competing for the ruling party Kulmiya. Yusuf Warsame Said, may Allah have mercy upon him, was an experienced civil engineer. I was expected to work on the improvement of the roads in the capital of Somaliland, for which he was elected. The Financial Subcommittee of the House of Representatives of Somaliland took part in a session with the Minister of Finance and the manager of the Central Bank, where the financial services of Somaliland were under discussion. Somaliland has seen economic growth recently, unlike previous years, and as such, the Financial Committee held this session to receive further insight into these developments.
The Finance Subcommittee of the House of Representatives of Somaliland conducted a hearing session for the Finance Minister and the Manager for the Central Bank. The purpose of this session between the Finance Subcommittee for the House of Representatives, the Finance Minister and the Manager of the Central Bank was to discuss more detail regarding the national financial plans, budget, the inflation and foreign currency exchange. Somaliland Minister of Finance, Abdulaziz Mohamed Somale, who spoke to media after session, said that the meeting was crucial for an update on financial information shared between all sides. The minister said that he and the manager of the Central Bank shared the whereabouts of the income and expenditure situation of the country. The chairman of the National Central Bank for Somaliland, Abdulaziz Tirir Abdi, also said that he shared with the Finance Subcommittee of the Parliament about the change in hard currency exchange rates that needs a stronger stance to counter inflation. About the change in hard currency exchange rates that needs a stronger stance to counter inflation.
The Minister of Fisheries and Marine Resources, Abdillahi Osman Gil Chire, received a delegation from the international humanitarian organization based in Denmark called the Somali Fishing Fair. This organization will assist in the development of maritime resources in Somaliland, a crucial sector for development.
Somaliland Minister of Fisheries and Marine Resources Abdullahi Chama Osman Gil Chire received a delegate from international humanitarian organization based in Denmark called Somali Fishing Fair. During the meeting, the international humanitarian organization and the minister deeply discussed key issues that are related to the ministry mandate of improving and enhancing Somaliland marine capacities, including the capacity building for the fisheries community in the coastal region of Somaliland. The minister mentioned that he welcomed and pledged to cooperate with a potential initiatives that will be for the benefit of Somaliland marine resource stakeholders. The vice chairman of the Somali Fishing Fair, Mahad Farah, who also spoke to the media after the meeting with the minister of fisheries and marine resource, said that the organization is going to focus on enable Somaliland community at large to make the marine resource useful.
You're still watching Somaliland National Television News English, the only Somali-speaking channel with an English news program. And now for our international news. Hundreds of delegates are meeting in Doha for a donor conference to raise support for the multi-billion dollar project to rebuild Sudan's Darfur region after a decade-long conflict. Hundreds of delegates are meeting in Doha for a donor conference to raise support for a multi-billion dollar project to rebuild Sudan's Darfur region after a decade-long conflict. The two-day conference, beginning on Sunday, was agreed under a July 2011 peace deal that Khartoum signed in the Qatar capital with allegiance of rebel splinter groups. peacetime has begun in Darfur, a peace that will be protected by development, not by force, said Qatari Prime Minister Hamad bin Jassim Al Thani at the opening of the conference. Jörg Hunel, team leader of the UN Development Programme in Sudan, said the conference would be a unique opportunity for Sudan and Darfur to turn the destiny of a conflict within the region. Britain on Sunday pledged at least $16 million for Darfur annually over the next 3 years to help communities grow their own food and provide skills training to help people find work. It is not enough to simply offer more handouts, said Lynn Featherstone, Britain's International Development Minister. Our aim is to help the poorest get the help they need to stand on their own and make them able to cope when crises occur. The development strategies call for agricultural upgrades, access to financing and other measures to help Darfuris support themselves under a more effective system of local government. Ahead of the meeting, protests against it were reported in refugee camps in Darfur, with demonstrators calling for an end to insecurity. Doha meeting comes 10 years after rebels rose up in western Sudanese region to seek an end to what was a domination of power and wealth among the country's Arab elites. Qatar brokered a peace deal between rebel faction and the Sudanese government in 2011, but the rebel groups like Justice and Equality Movement rejected it. The Doha peace deal was seen as a cornerstone in international efforts to end the violence, but hundreds of thousands of refugees forced to flee say that they can go home only when they are compensated for their losses. Sarajevo will be hosting the European Olympic Youth Festival, and although divided, the prospect of hosting the 2017 competition has prompted talk about how to work together. The prospect of hosting 2017 European Olympic Youth Festival has prompted talks about how Sarajevo City can work together. In 4 years, both parts of divided Sarajevo will be hosting the European Olympic Youth Festival. Bosnia and Herzegovina comprise the two parts, the Muslim Croat Federation with Sarajevo its capital, and the mainly Serb Republic, whose official capital is Eastern Sarajevo. Both administrations say they hope to cooperate over sports. Both city administrators say they hope cooperating over sports can have wider implications. At the moment, one of the main things the two sides share is scars of civil war. The EU's foreign policy chief has said that nuclear talks between Iran and six world powers have failed to reach an agreement.
The EU's foreign policy chief said that nuclear talks about Iran and six world powers have failed to reach agreement. The six incidents that Iran cut back to its highest grade uranium enrichment production and stockpile, fearing Iran will divert it from making nuclear fuel to form the material used in the core of nuclear warhead. Iran countered the proposal that focused in recognizing Iran's right to enrich uranium. He said, as the talks got underway on Friday, the six nations, the United States, Russia, China, France, and Britain, and Germany, sought to concentrate response from Iran to their February offer to ease sanctions if it stops its most sensitive nuclear work. The UN Security Council has demanded that Iran stop the process in several resolutions since 2006. The stakes are high because Israel, widely assumed to be Middle East's only nuclear armed power, has threatened to bomb the Islamic Republic atomic site if diplomacy fails. The chances of the talks succeed were scant, as Iran was not expected to make any major decisions on nuclear policy until after its presidential election in June. Western diplomats were hoping for serious discussion for the February proposal, under which Iran will have to close nuclear facility and ship some enrichment uranium stockpiles abroad in return of modest relief in sanctions of Iran, petrochemical and trade in gold and other precious metals. While no breakthrough have been expected, the lack of forward movement in international negotiation that started a decade ago is certain to increase Israel's concerns that diplomacy is effective as a tool to stop Iran from moving toward nuclear weapon-making capacity. Israel says Iran is only a few months away from thresholds of having materials to turn its bomb as pledge to use all means to prevent it from reaching that point. The Iranians are using the round of talks to pave the way toward a nuclear bomb, said Yuval Stanitis, the Israeli Minister of Intelligence and Strategic Affairs. In a text message, Israel already warned that Iranians are taking advantage of rounds of talks in order to buy time to advance in uranium enrichment step by step toward a nuclear weapon. The U.S. has not said what its red line is. It has said it will tolerate Iran armed with nuclear weapons.
Hundreds of Egyptians have taken to the streets to protest against President Mohamed Morsi and the Muslim Brotherhood, whose political wing controls the post-revolution first-elect government. Hundreds of Egyptians have taken to the streets to protest against President Mohamed Morsi and the Muslim Brotherhood, whose political wing controls the post-revolution's first-elect government. Protesters battled police in several Egyptian cities on Saturday, with at least 8 people reported injured, after rallies to mark the anniversary of key opposition movement turned to violence. In the capital, Cairo, police fired tear gas at hundreds of protesters outside the Superior Court, which also houses the officials of public prosecutors who had opened investigations against several dissidents. The prosecutor general angered activists a week ago by questioning a popular TV satirist who was accused of having insulted Morsi. The government denies opposition claims that the case is evidence of a crackdown on dissident. About 500 people marched for much of the day through central Cairo, chanting, "The people want to topple the regime." Live television showed footage of protesters throwing stones at police in armored vehicles amid burning tires on the main road near the court. The police fired heavy volleys of tear gas. Police also fired tear gas at protesters in the coastal city of Alexandria on the Nile Delta of Manhala, where demonstrators attacked police station with petrol bombs. Opposition and supporters of the Muslim Brotherhood attacked each other with stones and fireworks in Alexandria. The rallies were organized to mark the fifth anniversary of the march of the April 6th protest movement, which took off after a deadly police crackdown on labor strike in textile town Manhala on April 6, 2008. The Manhala clashes marked an escalation on a burgeoning protest movement against longtime ruler Hosni Mubarak, eventually overthrown in the 2011 popular uprising. In the Central African Republic, the country needs urgent food and medical help as coup leaders struggle to run the government. The United Nations warns of a humanitarian crisis in the Central African Republic. The world body says the country needs urgent food and medical help as coup leaders struggle to run the government. The rebel group in control of Central Africa Republica say there must be security before they can hold democratic elections. The United Nations say that since the group took over in the capital, Bangui, almost 2 weeks ago, a humanitarian crisis has developed in most of the country. And that's all the news we have for you today. Thanks very much for watching. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.